Hey, hello everybody, welcome to the Scientist Room. Today we are taking a look at GarageBand, GarageBand, and the new Base Future House, I think it's called, pack. So what you're going to do is install it. A lot of people ask me, where'd you get these sounds? Where'd you get these kits? You know, the new instruments and things. You need to be on at least iOS 12.1, I think, for all the new GarageBand stuff. First of all, we're going to go and hit this little plus icon here and search for Sound Library. This is where you're going to get all your stuff from, Sound Library. That's it, okay? So you will also see in this, like, keyboard, more sounds, stuff like that, more sounds. You can click on that as well. Go to Sound Library. Open it up here, and we're going to look at the Chromium Frey pack, which is base house pack, not future base. Chromium Frey, it's called. Okay, now there is another new one, which I haven't done yet, called Transition Effects, which is very cool. But all of this stuff is completely free here. So, you know, it'll tell you if it's downloaded or not. If it's not downloaded, it'll just say what it is. So we can open this and have a look at it here, and you will see that it contains over 300 Apple loops and more than 30 new synth sounds. And some of the synth sounds are designed for Alchemy, which requires iPhone 6 or later, or iPad Pro, iPad 5th generation, iPad Air, blah, blah. And then it contains 6 drum kits and 2 live loop grids. Okay, so let's get that pack, shall we? And click on pack, and it'll install pretty quick because it's not that massive. Okay, we're nearly there. There it is. And now it'll just say preview, or you can delete it again. So you're saving space on your iPad. So when you're done that, you can just tap outside it and then click done. Sorry, here, done. And then we can start to create a track. Now we can start with having a look at the beat sequencer where the new drums will be. And we can open this here like this, and we can go to recently added, okay? And then we can go to, where does it say, Chromium Frey. So it'll be there, all your stuff's there, so Chromium Frey. And there are your 6 new drum kits. So we'll start with this Bright Bass House. Just click on that and it'll load. Up. So the transport will stop and start it, and this will stop and start it for your kind of switches the machine on and off, but it gives you a a preview of the kits and stuff. So here are the different sounds in that particular Bright Bass House, and then we can go here any other time and we can scroll through different ones. So let's do that here, what they sound like. So this is what you get, sort of thing. So done, switch it on. So let's go with this one, which is quite straightforward. At any time we want to with the beat sequencer, with any of the kits or sounds, of course, is add another sound here, and you can add whatever you like. We could add a crash cymbal here. And you'll see they've already pre-programmed 2 patterns. You can jump to this one and put a cymbal in there. But we can take it out of that because we only need 1. Now, also, you can do, let me just turn it down a little bit. You can do some very cool stuff within the beat sequence itself. If you go to something like a velocity here, you can turn down the velocity for any of the instruments. So let's say for this clap, let's get a velocity ramp on this particular clap. So let's put some claps in here. I need to enter them. Okay, so let's choose velocity and let's turn that first one turn that one louder. So if we turn it up now, you'll hear it better. We've created like a velocity ramp, which is nice. We can also do this other very, very cool thing called note repeat. So let's put a few more of these. We need to be on step. Am I even hearing that? Yeah, it's too weird to hear. Let's put it on the clap. So if we go to note repeat, you can either hold on it like this and it'll expand it, it'll split it into two. So let's take this one out and that bass out there. So we're just hearing that clap. And you can make glitching effects. So you can So GarageBand doesn't respond to the crayon or pencil quite the same. If you want to see it better, just hold it and it will expand, and then you can get a better idea of how you're going to split this up. And then you can choose the loop start or loop end for any of the actual drums, which is quite nice. So we could do all sorts of nice, kind of get nice different vibe on the rhythms going. Put a few more drum hits in the bass. You can have the chant set for different hits. So if it's like really low, it's only a 23% chance of that hitting. And if you set 50, it'll be like kind of every other hit. There's a different kit again we can play with now. With our settings we've already made, sort of thing. We can stop that. Okay, so if you want to record that in, all you need to do is hit record and it will do it itself for you. So just tap record. And it, you know, it's initially set to 8 bars, but you can change that to anything you like. And the good thing is that you can set, let's stop now. Okay. You can make changes on the fly with any recording of a drum kit. So if we go back to our session view now here, you'll see that we've recorded our future house, and we can select it and delete it. And I'll show you something else that you can do if you want to record your drums in to GarageBand here. So what we can do is let's work with the second kit here, but we're going to record the whole thing in. So we're going to record this part and this part. I just want to mess with this bit as the loop is recording. So as the loop is recording, if we go back to our session view now, and we play the loop that we've just put in. The changes that I put in while it was playing will all be there. Which is very cool indeed. And then when you've got a kit that you're happy with, I want to show you a plugin effect that you can buy. I'll put a link in it called Beatformer by Acusonus, which is amazing. So this is going to make your beat sound incredible. You have to buy it if you want it. But anyway, I'm going to show you it anyway because it's very, very cool. And I'll give you an idea of what you can do to your beats. If we open up our little mixer settings here and we go to plugins and EQ, you can see that it's already got a few effects in there. The EQ is switched off, effects EQ is on, overdrive is switched on, bit crusher is off, so we could turn bit crusher on, but we don't want to do that, we'll leave that as it is. So what we're going to do is hit edit here, and then where it says none, we're going to add plus one there, and we're going to go to audio unit extensions, and whatever audio unit extension effects and stuff you've got there will be here. But I want to use this one called Beatformer, which I am going to put a link in the description for if you want to go and check it out the app store. So we open Beatformer like this, and then we just tap on the little icon to bring up the actual plugin, and there it is. So at the moment, it's on default, so you won't hear any difference between the actual loop that we recorded and the affected loop. So we can see our output and our input. So we can turn it up a little bit so we can hear what's going on. Let's make some adjustments to this. How cool is that? You can even tune your boom. Anyway, there you go. I'm not doing it. This is not a demo of Beatformer. I just wanted to show you the Beatformer is brilliant for really giving your beat some punch and kick. And then anytime we want to, we can edit and then we can remove said plugin like we can with the other stuff as well. Anyway, that is done. Okay, so let's see. Now, what else do we get? Let's have a look. We have got our drums here. Let's close our little, what's it there? So let's add a Alchemy synth because there are some sounds for Alchemy. I've got my little Akai LPK25 plugged in, so we can hear some MIDI sounds from the keyboard. Okay, so we're going to do an Epic Cloud Formation, which is the selector, our preset selector. And again, what we shall do is go to back to main categories, go recently added, go Chromium Fray, and this will bring up all the new sounds, and you'll see that they're all there. And like I said, if we choose this one, we can see it's an Alchemy sound. If we choose this one, it's an Alchemy sound. Eventually, it'll get to places like this where it'll go. Some of them won't be Alchemy sounds. We can find them. Quite a lot of them are, though. I know that some of them aren't. See, that one isn't, for instance. But these are all new sounds that have been added to the... These have all been added to the new. Mm-hmm. And then you can, of course... There's some seriously cool sounds in here. With all the alchemy ones, you can vary the sound, and also you have all the pages that you can play with. You can see along the bottom here, we can, if we swipe along, we can get to different sections of the synth that we can mess around with, which is very nice. And go back. And of course, what you can do as well, at any time you want, press done, you can play the, because we've got our pattern, you can play along with the pattern. You know, so you can kind of practice your bits. They've definitely gone for the bass. The sounds are mono, and a few of them are poly. This, obviously, this short, sweet plucks is poly. So there's only a couple of them that are on alchemy, actually. Right, okay. That's done with now. Okay, so let's go back to our What's It page. We never recorded anything in there. So at the moment, I'm going to get, I could leave this here for now. In fact, what I'll just do is I'll just mute it. Okay, Okay, let's go back to the beginning. And I'm going to go back to my songs. No, oh, no. Sorry, I'm not going to go back to my songs. I'm going to go back to here. And I'm going to go to our instrument picker. Seriously. Here are... Use the pen, the crayon. You use it, go with the instrument. I'm going to go to live loops now. They've included two live loops now. There are over 300 loops included with the new update, the Chromium Frame. So 300 new loops, which is huge. So what we're going to do is, once you've installed it, you'll see here that the last one on this page, it actually is called Chromium Frame. It says Chromium Frame underneath. The other one is located somewhere else, but you will see. Ah, there it is. It's called Bass House Masher and Chromium Fray. Let's just take a quick listen. They're both made up of the new loops sort of thing. So we can open this one. And it opens up, clean the screen. It opens up the live loops. Get rid of that there. It opens up the live loops like this. And at which point you can audition any of these by tapping on them. We can stop it like this. Or we can start a whole kind of, it's kind of like Ableton, but the other way around. You can start your, I guess you could call these scenes and these are clips. And so you can play any of as many as you like along this section, but you couldn't play all of those at the same time sort of thing. You get the idea, but anyway. The cool thing about live loops is you don't have to you don't have to stay with what this go back to the beginning. You don't have to stay with what they've got, of course. You can let's move that out of the way. You can mix and match. So for instance, you could do this. This is not a looped one. At any time you want to start editing these, you might want to add something to this, or you might want to change this particular or that. You might want to just change that to a one shot, for instance. You can hit the little edit button here, and then you can select that, and then you can go to edit. And this is where you can actually edit, you can actually just edit the actual sample. Or we can go back there. Let's get rid of this now. Or we can, we're still on edit. That's good. Let's long hold it there. And we can double tap it and we can find out the information. So at the moment it's looping. So we could switch looping off and it'll just play the actual thing. Play mode, you could have it play while it's pressed and that's all, or you could have it just re-trigger like din 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 sort of thing. Or like it, the other one was, like I said, you can have it just go with the looping off, so it just starts and then it stops. Follow tempo and pitch is a good idea to have on that. Just information tells you, you can tune it, transpose it as you can with an even, change the speed, or you can have it playing the other way around sort of thing if you want to. So you know, it's pretty good. Let's have it in reverse and see what happens. Let's get out of edit mode. See, it'll run backwards now. Well, it sounds pretty much the same forwards as it does backwards. But you can do that with any of them. And also, you can, if you select an empty, what's it, you can tap it. How long to hold edit? No, not sure. Anyway, I haven't messed with that, to be honest with you. But I know that you could... Oh, yeah. Sorry, you can. You just choose the loop that you want to use. Say it was this one, for instance, structured noise rise, and you move it out, and then you just drop it in. Okay, you can close that now. I can't put it on a MIDI track because it was what's it track. You can do it. Trust me. I'm going to try that one more time, actually. So I want to make sure that I've got this 70s electric piano, and I'm going to put that there. There it is. So that's it there. 70s electric piano. Get out of edit. And then you can do your further editing on it, etc., etc. Now, okay, so before we go, we've been quite a long time, but, you know, if you like GarageBand, I'm sure, you know, you can just skip bits and pieces, can't you? If we go to our picker now and we go to the other one, that's the Chromium Frey one, which is Bass House Masher, I'll show you some of the other cool things you can do. And what's really nice about GarageBand as well. Once we're in this mode, now I'm pretty sure I'm going to just select a new song because I may well be tied in to that 8 bars because I've got a drum pattern there, so I'm not sure. But I'll create a new song anyway, and I shall use, I'm on live loops and tracks, well, I'll do this one. And what'll happen, I'm going to record some bits and pieces in. Once it's loaded, there it is, there. I'll just make sure my volume's not too loud for this when it starts. But you can see that it's quite big. They've got quite a lot of loops going on in there. Let's have a listen to one. Okay, so stop it now. Okay, so I'm going to press record. And we can... Right, so let's press stop. What's brilliant now is that GarageBand will have recorded all our loops for us. So if we go to our sequencer view here, you will see that everything that I played and in the order it played, there we go, get it right in there, has been recorded as a session. So it'll... So by importing your own loops and stuff like this and then recording a session, and then, of course, you can add your own instruments and stuff. It really is very, very good. Anyway, guys, listen, I'm going to go because I've gone on for absolutely ages, 30 minutes, wouldn't it? Almost half an hour. Anyway, if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. Consider becoming a patron from as little as $1 a month. And there was a look at the new Chromium Frey pack for... GarageBand, yes, and very nice it is too. Okay, guys, see you later.